All right. So, yeah, news just came out, guys. Bearish news for S&P 500. One thing that I'm just keeping in mind, we didn't really have a gap today. So, I guess we'll see what we get. But this is the high of the week up here. Put in on Tuesday, and then this is the low put in yesterday. I really don't think we're going to breach either of those levels today. At least we shouldn't. I'm not going to say it can't happen, because anything can happen. But it's very rare that you're going to see a new low or a new high put in on Friday. Usually the high and or low of the week are put in, you know, between Tuesday and Thursday. So we've got that, essentially. We filled already 50% of this wick. Maybe we could aim for this high right up here, or these highs, this high right here, this high right here, if we get some bullishness. But we'll see. I mean, it was bearish news release, so I'm okay playing shorts if that's what we get. But let's drop down here to the 1 minute time frame. Like if we see price push up and grab this high and then obviously start displacing lower, then we can get short on this back down into some of these lows. But yeah, otherwise kind of open to whatever, but definitely wanted to wait till news release, which I'm glad we did. Market opened up right here, pushed down, and it's just been caught in this range. We're gonna play it like this. I'm waiting to see. We can get a break of structure entry maybe if we start coming, you know, pulling back down. Otherwise, I'm probably gonna take an entry, guys, off of the first fair value gap I see. So like if this candle ends up giving us a fair value gap in here, let's delete these lines. If we get a fair value gap in here, I'm entering off of this. And I'm just gonna, as of right now, I'm just gonna keep a 5-point stop, 5-point TP1. So if this fair value gap gets left open, wherever this fair value gap, if we get it, obviously, that'll be our entry. Now the trick is sending this in the Discord, because you gotta wait for the fair value gap to close, or the candle to close, to see if you have a fair value gap. Oh no, there is one, but it's tiny as shit. There is one, we'll enter off it. If we can, I'm gonna send this in the Discord quick. Yeah, if we pull back into this, I'm gonna enter. Bro, come on. Don't do this to us. Yeah, you guys see that? That is a fair value gap right here. I mean, what a... Get that F out of here, bro. Well, that's not what we wanted. You aped in? Oh, so you're aping in profit right now. Bro, oh my god. That's wild. I was talking about it as we were right inside of it too. That's why I'm annoyed. Yeah, I mean, I'm glad you guys are catching these. I'm glad you guys caught this. If you guys caught anything from this, I mean, it's just like, bro. This is my bad, guys. I should have called this fair value gap or this break of structure entry. We were still under that 50% equilibrium. Alrighty, we're getting down there. Came down awfully fast. okay. There we go. Alright. Right. Gave me a 5-point stop? Nah, we'll go up here. 4-point stop. And then this is a 1 to, actually, no, this is 10 points. Let's go ahead and just put this up here. All right, there's a trade. It is possible that we rip down here and grab this fair value gap. You know, but if that happens, I don't know what to tell you. It's not reacting the way that I wanted it to. Yup. There it is, stop loss hit. That sucks. Yup, that sucks. TP should have been hit. Stop that break even right there. Should have been the case. Wasn't the case. Took a loss. All I can do is be happy I set a stop loss, and that's it. I'm done trading for the week. So, yeah, it is what it is. But, yeah, I don't know if you guys have any questions about anything. Now we're going through that low of the week, so yeah, we might just be tanking from here. That was less than a 0.5% risk because it was a 4-point instead of a 5-point. And then yeah, that was, what was that on MetaTrader for me? Also less than a 0.5%. Yeah, I'm not gonna take any more trades, guys. It's just not the ideal day at this point. But am in profit on the week after EURJPY and yesterday on S&P 500. Not much, like literally 1.5%. So we escaped with a little bit of profit last week, a little bit of profit this week. Let's go, before we close the call, look at news next week, just see what we got coming.